lids are airtight to keep out the worms. We'll water your grass, treat your headstone with care, and that's about it, cause you ain't going nowhere. Cemetery mortuary. Our shovels are standing by.
And now, relax into Downward Dog.
Ooh.
What's wrong, Susan? Is this yoga class too hard?
No, I had a burrito for lunch and I'm feeling gassy.
Honey, this is Sweet Relief Yoga Studio. We don't hold anything back.
Now, swing your foot into Warrior 2.
Whoa, did she just?
Uh-huh.
And that's okay?
Does that answer your question?
Hi, I'm Carol Cutter, and here at Sweet Relief Yoga Studio, we believe letting go leads to true health.
Oh. Hold on, I'm gagging. True health. True health is what I was going to say.
You're good to go.
Okay, Mom, come on. You can do this. You need this job. Just turn your brain off and keep going. Is my mic on?
Tina, I don't know how to say this, but we're not going to be celebrating you on Secretary's Day. I try.
Okay, we're set.
I'm sorry, but these wrong answer of the game sponsors, these can't be real, yes? They're absurd. Look, if the price tag is high enough, I'll say whatever the hell you want, but I mean, come on.
Do you think you can cover just the last half of my shift for me?
Yeah, you mean like 4 hours?
Yeah, that'd be great. All you have to do is just check IDs when people come in, and if anyone's rowdy, just cuff them and put them in our holding cell.
I'm like 105 pounds and I'm 5'2".
Yeah, that's great. Here's some handcuffs. Here's some mace. Well, it's a mace bottle. I've used most of it for, you know, spraying on food, so it's empty. But people do still react to it when you pull it.
Hi, I'm Cookie Masterson. And anybody know how long you have to cook a chupacabra? Are you for part of a cult? There's your hardware. You can force another player to answer immediately by hitting your screw button. If they miss it, you win extra bonus dollars. And our wrong answer of the game is brought to you by
Team Sasquatch, a new drama on the Angst Network. He's mysterious, he's elusive, and he drives the girls wild. Like him. Mondays at 8.
Pick the wrong answer associated with our sponsor to win a fabulous prize and big cash. And right this way.
Get ready, time for crashing.
Run!
First question, not so smart Alec. What is Alec Baldwin most likely to scream at a dude with a camera who works as part of the paparazzi? Player 2, who gets the screw? You can't just leave your screw hanging out in the breeze like that. We'll try not to let that ruin the rest of the game. Player 1, no. Player 3, you're probably going to have to issue some kind of apology. Let me show you something. The singular term for paparazzi is paparazzo. And as a rule, paparazzi are borderline vile, but you still shouldn't f*** them in the f***ing f***. That's just sinking to their level. Oh, mama gonna tell you what I'm gonna do. Say it's all. Here's a good one. Drake a leg. Oh my god, for a second there I thought I saw my ventriloquist dummy Billy O'Brien again. I've been having visions of him just showing up at the most
inopportune times.
Ah!
One's made of skin, one's made of wood, so who's the dummy?
Not me.
It really is you.
It's always me, you dunny.
I was hoping you were just a mirage.
A mirage? That we're not in a desert. Oh, speaking of which, where would you be if you saw me as a mirage in the Gobi Desert? Pakistan, Mongolia, Peru, or Mexico?
Watch your time! Players 1 and 3?
Well, it's true that you're wrong.
Here's where the money is. Yes, the Gobi Desert is in China and Mongolia. Just don't sneak up on me anymore, Billy.
Okay, no trottling. Someday I'm gonna murder you.
I'm sorry, what was that?
Nothing, I didn't say anything.
Dance with me, Disco 3.
This one's called Shacking Up. Where should a large shacko be worn on Shaq O'Neal? His extra large ears, his big feet, his large head, or his massive hands? Time's a-wastin'! Player one. It's so obvious. Shakos are a military-style hat with a large feather in the front, often worn by marching band leaders. It would be the most ridiculous thing he's worn since Kazam. Player 3? Do you believe in Big Feet? Well, you should, because you just won an autographed poster of Ketor, the sexy Sasquatch star of Teen Sasquatch on the Angst Network. If you think Bigfoot was sexy before, you ain't seen nothing yeti. This wrong answer of the game has netted you an extra 4,000. Congratulations. How about Russian ladies looking for young men? And stop the train, it's a dis or dat. Player 2, your score stinks at the moment, so this one's all for you. I am going to list off 7 things, and for each one, I want you to tell me if it's something that happens to Anna Karenina in Tolstoy's classic novel, Anna Karenina, or a Justin Timberlake song. If it's Anna Karenina, press the square button. If it's Justin Timberlake, press the circle button. Now the rest of you should listen carefully. Make your selections before player 2, because if player 2 gets it wrong, everyone who got it right will split the winnings. Okay, let's move. Adultery. Birth. That performance was more depressing than the novel Anna Karenina. I keep meaning to reread Anna Karenina, but I've been waiting for a time when I really want to fall into a deep, deep depression. This one's known as Woody or Wouldn't He? What would it mean if Woody Allen were an alleged pedorthist? He's been accused of touching shoes, he's been accused of touching grapes, he's been accused of touching bugs, or he's been accused of touching feces. Time's running out. Anyone? Anyone? Okay, well, this is gonna be a blast. Here's what a right answer looks like. A pedorthist is a doctor or healthcare professional who focuses on feet, especially shoes and inserts that can help with pain relief. And look, I'm not saying he's a shoe doctor, and I'm not saying he's not a shoe doctor, but the one thing we can all agree on is that The Curse of the Jade Scorpion was a terrible movie. That about does it for round one. And player three is at the front of the class, with a comfortable cushion. Remember, in round two, every question is worth double. And don't forget about your screws. You didn't come here to make friends. Take a good look at Pup All Night. Considering their lifespans, which dog from the first Puppy Bowl would be the least likely to be alive to watch Puppy Bowl 11? That'd... Player one, who's gonna get it? You yanked out your screw, you got us all excited, and then you just sat there. Lame. Let's try to forget that ever happened. Players two and three.
Whoa.
Watch how easy this is. As a general rule, the bigger the dog, the shorter the lifespan. So the Great Dane, with a life expectancy of about 7 years, is, probably not going to make it. Oh, we're going to get some angry posts on our Facebook page about this question, I can tell. But it's not my fault we live in a world where horrible things happen!
Question seven!
Get up and shake your monkey bang!
I call this one, beautiful millionaires are just so relatable. Say the incredibly down-to-earth Jennifer Lawrence decides to go skydiving. If on her way down to Earth she reaches terminal velocity, what down-to-earth thing might you hear her say? Wowzer, I could not be going down to Earth any faster. Aw, man, I'm going down to Earth slower every second. Lol, I broke the sound barrier on my way down to Earth. Or, cool beans, I'm actually now going away from Earth. Not much time left. Amazing, we got a room full of spineless wimps. Watch closely. A falling object or adorable movie star that has reached its terminal velocity will not speed up anymore on its descent before hitting the ground. It's falling as fast as it can. But even if she fell to her death, I bet Jennifer Lawrence would leave the most adorable crater.
Follow me down to the sea.
Up next... Kangaroo, Peanut, Albert Einstein, or Uranus?
Kangaroo, Peanut, Albert Einstein, yo! Or Uranus?
Closely associated with Miranda and Ariel. Kangaroo, Peanut, Albert Einstein, or Uranus? Almost up. Players one and three. Miranda and Ariel are two of the larger moons of Uranus. And you can't have moons without Uranus. Hey, we were supposed to have a tuba there to accentuate the butt joke. Where's the tuba guy?
He was in a car accident on the way over, Cookie. He's dead.
Hey, trombone guy made it! Open wide for... Ay caramba! I'm a cold-blooded killer! Say Bart Simpson decides to start going around attacking authority figures with his slingshot. If it turns out like the story of David and Goliath, what might happen? Principal Skinner will die after getting shot in the forehead. Chief Wiggum will die after getting shot in the gut. Mayor Quimby will die after getting shot in the heart. Or Homer Simpson will run away after getting shot in the groin. Watch the time! If you didn't want to play, why the hell did we even get started? How about this for a right answer? David slays Goliath after slinging a stone into the middle of the giant's forehead. So that's how Principal Skinner might meet his untimely demise as well. But it really wouldn't be that much of a loss. Springfield is literally crawling with people who sound exactly like him. And now, I'm gonna need two oceans of calamine lotion, stat. If the 80s hairband poison were like poison ivy, what part of them would give people a rash? The fumes from their hairspray, the oil in their makeup, the silk on their rockin' clothes, or the ink in their tattoos? Time is short. Layers 1, 2, and 3. Coming in contact with the oil on a poison ivy plant is what causes the skin to break out in a rash. So if the band poison were similar, it would probably be best not to touch their oily makeup. In fact, it's probably best not to touch any part of the band poison. You have no idea where they've been for the past 25 years.
Welcome to the attack. When you see two clues that match, press the X button. 2,000 big ones if you're right, but you lose 2,000 if you're wrong. And don't forget... I'm sorry, was I talking too much? Fine, here's your clue. Climb time. What did these guys climb? Good luck.
About your win, okay? You ended up with zero. You did as well as if you'd spent the entire game in a coma. Wait, wait, Player 4's lips are moving. I can barely make out the words.
You don't know Jack!
Hey,
My name is Jaden Funk, and I want to teach you slam poetry. But talk is cheap, right? Cheap like a toy made in China by kids in sweatshops working 9 to 5 like Dolly Parton. The interruption. But North Korea just dropped a nuclear bomb on us. Just...